She was just walking down the street singing do-a-di-di-di-di-dum-di-di-dum. Popping her fingers and shuffling her feet singing do-a-di-di-di-di-dum-di-di-dum. She looked good.
She looked good.
She looked fine.
She looked fine.
She looked good.
She looked fine. And I nearly lost my mind.
Hey guys, thanks for joining us today on the Tip of the Week. We are trying to get back to basics this week and get your buyers qualified. I'm Joe Cordova.
I'm Brad Zerbe.
And we wanted to talk a little bit today about pre-approval versus pre-qualification.
Pre-approval is where the borrowers, your buyers, have actually come to us, submitted their documents to us, and we've also run credit, and we know what they're actually able to qualify for. Whereas a pre-qualification...
Yeah, pre-qualification is when you basically interview a buyer over the phone, they tell you their income, their assets. We do run their credit, but we're kind of going on their word. So obviously, when working with a buyer, you want to be working with a pre-approved buyer.
Correct. Guys, it's quite simple. It's about the ability to repay, and we're looking for three things: income, assets, and credit.
Yep. And with income, it's pretty simple. If you're a W-2 employee, we want the most recent month of pay stubs, the last 2 years of your tax returns and W-2s. Now, with your tax returns, we want all pages of your federal tax returns. One of the nuances on your Schedule A is unreimbursed business expenses, and an underwriter is going to discount that if you've claimed any. Yeah, they're going to discount it off your income, so make sure we have all pages of your tax returns. And for self-employed buyers, we want the last 2 years. If they're a corporation, we want their corporate returns as well, and potentially a profit and loss statement for the current year.
Now, as far as assets, we're typically looking for the last 60 days on any accounts, checking, savings, money markets, CDs, things like that. If they have a 401k or some sort of retirement account, generally we want their most recent quarterly statement. And then if they have other assets beside that, if needed, we can show them. If they're not necessary to approve the loan, we can maybe discount them and not use them at all.
And another thing with assets, with bank statements, if it's page 1 of 3, the underwriter wants to see
all three pages.
If it's double-sided, make sure to copy the back side of the page. We see that all the time. And credit, guys, generally we're looking for over a 640 credit score to qualify for most of our mortgage products. Now, we can go as low as a 600 credit score for some of our products, but keep in mind, the higher your credit score,
better the rate,
the better the interest rate. So we'll take a look at that for you as well. And we have some products that can actually help you increase those credit scores with a few maneuverings of balances on credit accounts. So whether you're working with a first-time home buyer or someone who hasn't bought a home in a while and might be selling a home now, make sure we can get these documents from them so basically we can
get them pre-approved.
Get them pre-approved. With that, have a great weekend. Do us a favor, forward this along to anyone who may need this information. Leave us a comment below, and we'll see you next week.
Take care.
Take it easy.